From the newsroom at news.com.au.
G'day, I'm Andrew Bucklow, and this is the latest from the newsroom. It's Friday, the 3rd of December. The Australian Technical Advisory Group on Immunisation has recommended that no widespread changes be made to Australia's COVID booster rollout. Despite the emergence of the Omicron variant, Chief Medical Officer Professor Paul Kelly said that Atagi was confident the booster shots did not need to be brought forward.
At the moment, the Atagi advice has been, once people have reached a six-month stage since their second dose, that they should have that booster. It's really important now, with the emergence of the Omicron variant, that we do go ahead and get that booster when people are due.
Moving on, more details have come to light about last night's $80 million Powerball winners. It turns out a group of 55 women who go to the same gym in WA decided to pool their money and ended up taking out the major prize. Here's what one of them had to say on 6PR this morning.
At the gym a couple of days ago, our leading light lady that runs the gym said, "I think we should put in for Powerball. Come on, $5 each." And I scraped a couple of coins together out of my parking ticket money, and they had their Christmas party last night, but I couldn't go. I had another function. So I came home, hopped into bed, checked my phone, and I had all these missed calls. And I thought, why would the gym be calling me? So I rang them back and I said, "What's happening? I hope you're ringing to tell me, you know, we've won Powerball." And she said, "Yeah, we have."
Each of the women will walk away with about $1.5 million each. In other news, it appears us Aussies are the heaviest drinkers in the world. A global drug survey asked more than 32,000 people from 22 different countries to monitor their alcohol consumption in 2020 in order to obtain a snapshot of global drinking habits. Aussies got drunk an average of 27 times over the course of the year, which was almost double the global average. Cheers to that. To New York now, one of Jeffrey Epstein's former house managers has testified at Ghislaine Maxwell's sex trafficking trial. The man claimed that Maxwell gave him a 50-page instruction manual for how to behave around Epstein, which included never looking him in the eyes and to remember that he should see nothing, hear nothing, and say nothing. He also testified that he saw a slew of young women lounging around the mansion, most of the time topless. Maxwell is on trial for charges related to her alleged participation in Epstein's sexual abuse of minors. She has pleaded not guilty. To showbiz, Machine Gun Kelly has revealed that he accidentally stabbed himself in the hand while trying to impress his girlfriend, Megan Fox. Here's what he told Jimmy Fallon.
"Travis got me this, he got me a knife that was that had an engravement from the new album on it. And I was like, oh, check this out, this is sick. And I threw it up and it came and stuck in my hand. Do you see that right here?
I do see that.
Yeah, that was from when a knife stuck in my, because you know how you throw it up and you're supposed to catch it? I looked at her, I was like, check this out." And I was like,
"You are the coolest dude I've ever met in my life, Kissy."
And then the next morning, as soon as she left, I was like, "Yo, I need stitches real quick."
Yeah.
And finally, Peter Hellyer has revealed that he caught COVID from another Aussie celebrity. The comedian had the virus last month and said he most likely got it from Kate Langbrook. Well, that's the latest from the newsroom. We'll be back with another update soon.
Get the latest from news.com.au.